piece.
It's for me. I hope that's a straight line. I don't have a ruler. That's the problem. I know I could do it with tape. It would be a lot better
to do it with tape.
Breaking up already. That should have stayed nice and even. And not break so fast. It's probably not a good quality tape, that's why it's breaking so fast. Shouldn't break this fast at all. gonna keep going back to some of my resin art, because I notice I get more likes with my resin art, so I don't know about this abstract thing. I'm just mixing the paint with a little bit of gesso to give it texture, so when I paint the metal, it has some sort of Studio 54 girl. Yeah. So my mom got me out of there. Said I heard this drug there. I don't want to do no more. Yes, mom. Gotta do what mom says. And that's it. My phone is kind of over. Thank you. has a little scrape on it. If it has a little, if it's an old brush and it has a little cut on it or something wrong with the actual brush itself, it's not going to be good. So it has to be a smooth brush that you can guide it all the way through. Ability. Let's see when I pull off the tape. I gotta pull off the tape now. That's what I should do now, because now I know more or less where my middle is. Okay, it's coming off there, but yeah, I think it's, I should just pull off the tape. The tape's gonna come off. Watch. If I didn't want any mark on the canvas from the tape itself, you could always take a blowtorch, a blowgun, not a torch. You don't want to burn your canvas. You could always take a blowgun and just go through it with the blowgun over the tape. And it would take it right off so that the paint wouldn't come off with it. At this point, it's okay. I could redo it, so it's not a problem. I already know more or less what I'm going to do. And it's going to be just a simple paint. It's not going to be anything outrageous and big. Those middle colors are going to be thick is by me mixing it with the jet gesso, it kind of takes over and gets rid of the blue, kind of makes that like a light blue instead of a dark blue. Unless I put a lot more paint, which I don't have. Well, that makes it better. It makes it look like a braid. I just put a braid there, so that's a good thing. Now, the next color I have to do that to is the pink right next to it. It's kind of slowly fading away, that pink. So I'm just going to mix it up with the gesso a little bit here. I like when it flies like that with a point on it. It makes it look more abstract, kind of. Yeah. Alright, just get the purple going and some more of that little bit of that red, and then I'm done. And I'll get just the background. A little exhaustion going on here with the little lady. 61, going on 62, but really 60. I'm going on 35. That's what my son tells me. Mom, you're more like you're going on 35 the way you act. I said, well, I'm happy that all your friends love me. When I go with him to Miami, he's not afraid to take his mom out to the club. I just went one side. I told him, you know what, it's your turn to have a ball in the club, not my turn. My turn is over. I already had all that. I had a very good upbringing. Glad my mom let me open up to everything possible, every possibility in the world. Glad my mother installed that in all of us. Go have fun. You only get to live once. That was her main words to us. Many reds, my reds are all running out. I had about a good 5 or 6 reds, and they're all going because kind of abstract painting. You like to use a lot of red in the abstract painting, which is what a lot of galleries like. The abstract red. This is a painting I just finished, my abstract painting, and I have to go over right here. I'm still painting it, and you could tell it's still wet. So I'm gonna just let it sit for tonight and go over certain areas. Love you all. God bless. Bye bye.